Due to the nature of building a custom computer, you may find compatibility issues with the following parts list. Today I'm here with the next in my series of computer build videos, this time at the $600 price point. For a very reasonable amount, you will be able to build yourself a gaming PC that can run most any game on the market today at high or even maxed graphics settings. The starting point is going to be an Intel Core i3-2100. As one of the new Sandy Bridge CPUs, this features a dual-core design clocked at 3.1 GHz, which combined with hyper-threading and some Intel magic makes for a CPU that will match, if not exceed, many older generation quad-core processors for $125. For a motherboard, we're going to use the Biostar TH67 Plus. Since the i3-2100 is incapable of overclocking anyway, we can save some nice cash by going with an H67 board. You still get a nice variety of features, including 4 slots of DDR3 RAM, a pair of SATA 3 6 Gbps ports, along with 4 SATA 2 ports and 2 USB 3, all on a micro ATX board for $90. The graphics card for the build is a XFX Radeon 5770. This is an outstanding last generation GPU that features DirectX 11 support, an 850MHz core clock along with one HDMI port, a DisplayPort, and 2 DVI connectors. In addition, it comes with a fantastic XFX lifetime warranty and great customer service. This will run you $105 after rebate. For the memory, we'll use a pair of 2GB PNY RAM sticks for a total of 4GB. Each stick is clocked at 1333MHz in dual channel for this build. This is more than sufficient for most games out there, and leaves room for adding additional memory in the future if you need it. Not bad for $37 after a mail-in rebate. $600 isn't quite enough to afford a SSD in our build, so we're going to use a Seagate Barracuda 7200 RPM hard drive with 500GB of capacity. This is a good compromise between speed and size, and is a great deal for $40 currently. A DVD burner is certainly optional these days, however it's still a useful feature, so we'll use a LITE-ON CD DVD burner for $21. Although we could easily cheap out and get a micro ATX case with an integrated power supply, instead we're going to use an Antec 300 ATX mid-tower case and Thermaltake TR2 500 watt power supply. By spending the extra money, we get a larger, higher quality case, giving lots of room for future upgrades, in addition to plenty overhead as far as power is concerned. $85 for the pair after rebates isn't half bad. Last but not least, we have a shiny new System Builder copy of Windows 7 Home Premium 64-bit. If you already have a copy of Windows, you can easily skip out on this, but otherwise this will run you a cool $100. So how much did we end up burning through the debit card? As of April 26, 2011, the entire list will run you $592.87 after all mail-in rebates and combo offers on Newegg.com. Of course, since this is a custom build, feel free to customize it to your own liking, but overall, if you're interested in PC gaming, this should get you up and running with a nice rig without breaking the bank.